Florists are all working overtime, all hoping to clip the competition with the clock ticking.
KETV NewsWatch 7's Kristyna Engdahl reports.
Florists expect thousands of orders this Valentine's Day. And just like every year, they plan for last-minute shoppers.
Typically, because it's a male demographic, males put things off to the last minute, and Monday afternoon is when a lot of them start ordering.
That's why Taylor's Flower Shop is open on a Sunday, a day they're usually closed.
We'll keep the door open until the last customer gets here, actually, within reason.
This is a behind-the-scenes look inside the store's warehouse. This huge walk-in freezer is where designers make bouquets, preparing well in advance for Tuesday.
Each girl does their assembly of 30 of this arrangement, 30 of the next arrangement, and so on and so forth.
It keeps their walls of creations cool, but not too cold, because just seconds of exposure to freezing temperatures can kill your flowers.
Because one of the biggest problems we have is people taking those flowers unwrapped from work, put them in their car, and then on the way home they freeze.
Taylor's expects to build about 1,000 bouquets for Valentine's Day, helping out shoppers like Jack Smith.
I've been giving her roses since she was 15 years old.
He's buying flowers for his wife.
She was 15 and I was 17 when we met, and it's just a thing I do.
And Taylor's Flower Shop looks forward to a competitive edge on Tuesday.
We compete with the restaurants on when it falls on a weekend for taking someone out to dinner rather than sending flowers.
Reporting in Omaha, Kristyna Engdahl, KETV NewsWatch 7.
Many florists let you order through Valentine's Day, but be ready for a limited selection the longer you wait.